At the moment, it's the only small horse breed that survives in the Greek islands. It's possible that some horses at some point went to the island and they adapted to the local conditions, and that's why they are smaller. From far away, you don't realize that they are so small because they are well proportioned. They have the same proportions as a larger horse.
A breed definition of the Scyrian horse is no taller than 1/16 of the withers, preferably smaller. No white markings of any kind, so no white stars, no white socks. To be a block colour, bay, dun, dark brown. A thicker mane and tail, which is more kind of non-domesticated horse. Strong, hard hooves. Expressive eyes, not a particularly pretty face, but a handsome head.
In the island there was a much larger population until the Second World War, and a few thousand horses, and they were used in agriculture.
We were concerned about, one, the welfare of the Scyrian horses, that they were not in great shape, they weren't in good condition, but two, really concerned about there not being a definable breed, that there were very few ponies that looked the same. We became both interested from a conservation perspective, but also from a welfare perspective. And then Stathi very much was like, but within that we have to have an education perspective to change local people's opinion about what the Scyrian horse is, how we should look after it, how we should protect it.
The university got involved because they wanted to reconstruct the pedigrees, especially for a breed that is small in numbers. It is important to know the relationships between the animals so that inbreeding is avoided.
When we first started off, we were breeding, and that was our main concern. From the horses that we've bred, that we've kept, we then could begin to train those horses for riding, train those horses for driving, train those horses for equine agility. So exploring different ways that the pony has value in a contemporary society, and in a society such as Greece, where there's not a long history of equine activities. By moving on the ponies that we've bred and are now able to go off into the big wide world and hopefully promote the Scyrian pony and the island, we can then breed with the mares that we've bred, which are better quality than the mares we originally had, to produce hopefully even better quality Scyrian horses.